Good morning, children. How are you all? All had a great weekend. Children, lesson 1, English. Peter enters the garden. Here, Peter is the name of a rabbit. And a garden, you know, a place where you grow plants, flowers, fruits and vegetables. Okay? Pounder, roll a rabbit. For this activity, you need a playing dice, a pencil, and an eraser. Roll the dice and start drawing the rabbit. Follow the chart to know which part to draw first. Last class, I asked you all to draw a rabbit, right? Yeah. Here's the instruction how to draw a rabbit. Now, in this box, you need to draw a rabbit. Follow the instructions according to the dice 1, dice 2, dice 3, dice 4, 5 and 6. According to this, you have to draw the rabbit here. Now, write a line about your rabbit. Now, I know most of you don't have rabbit, but you can write about a rabbit, okay? Or maybe you had before, or in your uncle's house, your aunt's place. Anyway, so you write about the rabbit, okay? Now, did you know some species of rabbits live in a burrows? A group of burrows is called a warren. Rabbits have good sense of hearing and sight and an excellent sense of smell. These senses help them to detect predators. Now, these rabbits, they live under the ground. Their home is there only. And rabbit, they have a good sense of hearing. And they can see well and smell well. And they also can sense if somebody is going to catch them too. Now, let's see here. Why do you think adults make rules for children about where they can go and cannot go? Yes, adults. Say, suppose your teacher or your parents says, don't go here, don't go there, don't do this, don't do that. Right? We always give you an advice. Did you ever think why we keep on telling you to do, to give you advice like that? Yes. So, something should not go wrong. So, teachers, your aunt, your uncle, your parents, they give you a advice. Okay? Yes? So, they make a rule for you to do this or not to do this, right? Let's turn into a new lesson. Peter enters the garden. Now, here it is. Beatrice Potter, 1866 to 1943, was a British children's author and illustrator. She's the best known for her stories, such as those in the Tale of Peter Rabbit. She was very fond of nature and was a conversationist. Now, she's a Potter Beatrice Potter, and she was a British English author, okay, who wrote this lesson, okay, the story of the Tale of Peter Rabbit. She was fond of nature. You know nature, right? Yes. Things around us. Let's go here. Once upon a time, there were 4 little rabbits. What? How many rabbits? 4 little rabbits. Their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. What are their names? Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. Okay, they lived with their mother underneath the root of a very big tree. Can you see her tree? Yes, underneath this, they lived here. Who lived here? Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail and Peter lived here inside this under a very big tree. Now, my dears, said old Miss Mrs. Rabbit one day. You may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident there. So the mother told her children, you can go into the fields, down the lane, but don't go to Mr. McGregor's garden because your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor's. Now run along and do not get into mischief. So mother is giving advice to her children. Okay, you can go and play, but don't go to Mr. McGregor's garden and don't get punished and don't get into any mischief. I'm going out. Who's going out? The mother is going out. Sometimes our mom also says, no, I'm going out. Be a good child at home. Don't do this and that. Don't do any mischief things, right? Same thing, Mother Rabbit, she said, don't do any mischief thing. You can go down and play. Then old Mrs. Rabbit told, then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the wood to the baker's. Now, you know what is a baker's, right? Yes, where you can buy some bread, you can buy some bun, or you can buy some things from there. So mother gone to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns. So she went there. She bought how many loaf of bread? She bought a loaf of bread and 5 currant buns. Do you think the 4 little rabbits would listen to their mother? What do you think will happen next? Now children, do you think these rabbits really listen to their mother, whatever she has advised them? Let's see here. Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. Who? Flopsy, Mopsy and Cottontail. They listened to their mother and they went down the lane. They started to gather blackberries. But Peter, who? Peter, who was very naughty, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden. Who? Peter. Did he listen to his mother? No. So he ran and he went straight into Mr. McGregor's garden and squeezed under the gate. First, he ate some lettuce and some French beans, and then he ate some radishes, and then feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley. But around the end of cucumber frame, who should he meet but Mr. McGregor's. Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees planting young cabbages. But he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rack and calling out, stop thief! So, now we see here, Peter did not listen to his mother. He started to go into McGregor's garden and started to eat some lettuce, French beans, radishes and some parsley. And then he was very full. So, and he got caught with who? McGregor's. And McGregor started to, what he started to? Chase him, right? Can you see the picture here? Started to chase him and called him, you thief. Yes. Will Mr. McGregor catch Peter? If he does, what do you think he would do with Peter? Now, do you think that McGregor will catch Peter? If he does, what do you think that he would do with Peter? So children, did you understand the story here? I'll stop here. Okay. Yes. You can see the mother and the four little rabbits. The three little rabbits listen to their mother and they are down the lane. They are gathering some blackberries. But Peter, he entered into Mr. McGregor's garden, which was advised by his mom not to go into Mr. McGregor's garden, because already his father had an accident there. So Peter did not listen. He disobeyed his mother here. I'll stop from here, children. Thank you. I'll continue tomorrow.